My barber quit. I have no barber. My hair is getting long. Mitch McConnell isn't backing down in his standoff with Donald Trump. In mid-April, the Senate Leadership Fund, which is a super PAC aligned with McConnell, announced that it had booked more than $7 million worth of TV ad time in Alaska. Yes, Alaska. Now, that spending is in support of GOP Senator Lisa Murkowski as she tries to fend off a challenge from Kelly Schiavacca, who has been endorsed by the former president. Now, the move to defend Murkowski isn't terribly surprising. McConnell has made clear all along that he supports Republican incumbents up to and including Murkowski. Quote, "It's important for Lisa to be reelected. She's one of the few sort of moderates in the middle of the Senate," McConnell said in early April, adding this, "We're going to do everything we can to make sure she's successful." End quote. Now, the Super PAC's decision to commit $7 million, which is as much as Murkowski spent on her entire 2016 re-election race, means that McConnell is sending a not-so-subtle message to former President Trump. It's time to put up, or...
shut up.
Shut up?
Shut up.
Trump, you see, has been talking about beating Murkowski for, well, a long time now. Last June, Trump endorsed Schiavacca's candidacy, although he did spend much of his time announcing that endorsement running down Murkowski. Quote, "Lisa Murkowski is bad for Alaska," Trump said. "Murkowski has got to go." End quote. The root of Trump's dislike for Murkowski appears to be her willingness to break with him and other party leaders. The biggest break was when Murkowski was one of seven Republican senators to vote to impeach Trump for his actions on and around January 6th, 2021. Quote, "If months of lies, organizing a rally of supporters in an effort to thwart the work of Congress, encouraging a crowd to march on the Capitol, and then taking no meaningful action to stop the violence once it began is not worthy of impeachment, conviction, and disqualification from holding office in the United States, I cannot imagine what is," Murkowski said in explaining her vote to convict Trump. Now, unlike her other six Senate colleagues who voted for Trump's impeachment, Murkowski is up for re-election in 2022. And as Trump did with the 10 Republicans in the House who voted for his impeachment, the former president is making it his mission to defeat her. Quote, "I will not be endorsing under any circumstances the failed candidate from the great state of Alaska, Lisa Murkowski," Trump said in a statement in March 2021. Good to see he's pro-Alaska. He added this, quote, "She represents her state badly and her country even worse. I do not know where other people will be next year, but I know where I will be, in Alaska, campaigning against a disloyal and very bad senator," end quote. But aside from his big talk, it's not at all clear, at least to me, what Trump is or is going to do to make good on his pledge to beat Murkowski. Sidebar. Count me as very skeptical that Donald Trump will make his way all the way to Alaska to campaign against Murkowski. On the fundraising front, at least, the race at the moment isn't particularly close. As of March 31st, Murkowski had more than $5.2 million in the bank to spend on the race, while Schiavacca had less than $1 million. And now, with McConnell's super PAC weighing in for Murkowski, the advantage is very much on the incumbent side, and it is massive. Who, you ask, could help close that financial gap? How about the former president? His Save America PAC had $110 million, yes, you heard that right, $110 million in the bank as of the end of February. Except Trump doesn't seem inclined to spend down that money. As the New York Times noted in a terrific recent piece on the Trump Political Organization, and I quote, "Mr. Trump can be downright stingy. Though he holds rallies for some candidates, for many, his support goes no further than an email and a $5,000 check. Mr. Trump has almost never deployed his huge list of supporters to help other politicians raise money," end quote. Now, might that stinginess be changing? Trump's PAC did recently give $500,000 to a super PAC attacking Georgia Governor Brian Kemp. So maybe he's had a change of heart. But if the past is prologue, and it is, Trump prefers to spend his money on, well, himself and his own political best interests. And it's not immediately clear whether giving Schiavacca a big chunk of change fits into those plans. What we do know is that Mitch McConnell isn't screwing around in Alaska, and the ball is now very much in Donald Trump's court. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.